Welcome to ATB-TV. I'm Darren Dance here in the twilight with Peter Morgani.
Very twilight here.
Twilight ATB-TV because I'm running late, probably about an hour late in the truck because I've got to come and pick up Think Babe and Captain Harry.
Yeah, both.
Both to the paddock.
End of their preps. Yeah, well, a short one for Captain Harry, unfortunately.
Gone shinsaw, but yeah. Think Babe, we'll get to that later.
No worries.
But let's go back through our results before we're in the pitch black.
Yeah. We're not going to get no hope from Silver Stratum over here. He's a bloody snob.
So got no interest.
No interest whatsoever. We have to wind back to last Friday. Obviously, yep. We had the carnival. We went through all those last week. We had Silver Stratum and Streets of Dubai, both running well.
Yeah, I thought Streets of Dubai first up over 1300 was a really good
yep.
run. Obviously, his plan was to go back, settle, and then run home late. And of course, over that distance, when they accelerate, they do get left flat-footed, and then he picked himself up and hit the line nicely. And hopefully, he's in for a good preparation. Silver Stratum was a bit the same, wasn't he?
Yeah, like, similar runs.
You know, we thought he was a place chance, and he ran third. Yeah. And look out for him next start if he gets a bit of rain.
He's certainly a lot more dour, I reckon, this prep. That sprint.
You've always liked him, haven't you?
Oh, he's a favourite, I suppose. Just depends on what happens this prep. Sunday, we had nothing Saturday. Sunday, we had a couple in, but we scratched Craig and Air.
Too wet.
Our approach.
Should have scratched
her.
Yeah. Waste of time.
And we all
anyway,
know
anyway, she's gone to the paddock. She doesn't handle wet, so it's a waste of time having her in work.
Yep. Obviously, we had our international. It was a bittersweet sort of moments with our internationals. Obviously, Tiberian won, and Darren, you might want to touch on Heartbreak City, which knocked us for six.
Let's start with Tiberian, our new international, and it was nice to see him win that Group 3. He's had two starts for us now and won them both, and he's a very nice horse. Only a four-year-old colt. Bought him with a plan to come to the Melbourne Cup maybe this year, if not this year, next year, but he's guaranteed a run now at 54 kilos, so he's qualified and he's in. Unfortunately, we lost Heartbreak City on Saturday night in a gallop at the Curra as the final gallop to the race. Unfortunately, he snapped his leg and had to be euthanized, so that's gut-wrenching and heartbreaking for all the owners and, you know, just can't believe it, really, Pete. You know, the horse, you know, he's a hurdler, and I thought if anything was going to go wrong, it was going to happen over the jumps, but I didn't really expect it to happen on the flat, having a gallop as a lead-up. So, you know, all that work, the relationship with Tony Martin and the whole ownership group, including the Irish boys who live in America, you know, that's gone now, been taken away from us prematurely. So all I can say is that you know, everyone concerned, and look, we've been overwhelmed with the emails and letters that have come through and the messages of condolences, and you know, it's heartbreaking. And you know, even though we won on Monday night, it still left me feeling really flat. But I don't know how long it takes to get over it. We lost Toyu back in February, and I don't think I'm really got over that. You know, never had a horse break its leg in my life, and I've had two in 3 months.
I've got a little tribute at the end of today. Obviously, it was not only with us, but he had a bit of a cult following in Australia.
Yeah. Great horse, great people.
There's one that'll
unfortunately taken away.
We moved to Tuesday and we had Rocket Cod first up for the David Hayes stable. Run a very nice second. He settled back and got home really well.
Great run.
Yeah.
He'll be winning next start. Two-year-old taking on the older horse on the synthetic and really hit the line well.
Yeah, one to follow for a while. Righto, we move along to Wednesday. Not much joy at Sandown with Think Babe, who we've just loaded on the truck to go home for a spell, and Tintaglia.
Yeah, well, Think Babe started odds on, pretty much even money favourite. Was expected to win by everybody, including us and Darren Weir, but unfortunately, he's mucking around the gate at the start, Pete, and nosedive when the gate's open. Bruised his nose on the grass, pulled his shoe off, and then he sort of got going and got him to the lead. But unfortunately, the damage was done. Galloping with one shoe and probably strained some muscles in his front, so he's been sent to the paddock. He's a good horse. He's had five runs this prep, and he's been going really well. And I'm sure he's a stakes horse in the making, but I'm glad he's going out now for a month, and we'll set him up for the spring. Tintaglia was having her first up run for the new stable of Archie Alexander. Look, I think by the time we'd finished briefing the jockey, young Ethan Brown, I think he didn't probably want to ride it. So he's told him to pull his arms out of his sockets and hang on for dear life and get an escort. But really, she was on her best behaviour. And she jumped and settled and travelled and just worked it on the corner and then hit a top and just whacked away to the line, which is, you know, she's a stayer. So probably third up over 2,400 will be her go.
Yep.
But I was really impressed with her run, as was Archie.
Yeah.
And I think the jock was wondering what all the fuss was about. But I'm sure, I think we came away sort of running, you know, getting beat a fair way, but just good for the future because she looked great. She was really relaxed and, yeah, just the change in environment, I think, has just switched her on.
Yeah, no, for sure. I mean, that young Ethan Brown did ride a double earlier in the day. So,
he's a good rider.
Yeah, he goes good, the kid.
And a nice kid.
Yep. Today, as we stand here, we had Himiji Joe run about 3 hours ago at Swan Hill. And, I listened to Dean. She jumped, but she just hasn't got that speed to use the inside gates. She was probably just fair to the line running fifth, beating three lengths, probably two and a half.
Yeah, beating three lengths. I don't know, look, I thought he rode her all right. I don't think he could have rode her any better, but she just didn't have the ping, did she? So I don't know whether that was because they didn't go hard enough early, or whether they sprinted too quick, or whether she was just outclassed. I don't know. I don't know what Dean said, but I thought, you know, favourites, she might have won that, but I think we had won four leading up to it, so well, no hope of winning.
No.
But, you know, at the end of the day, you know, she's probably a little bit limited. I'm not sure. She's had quite a few runs in this prep.
Probably at half a dozen more.
Plus she had a bit of a virus there halfway through. So, you know, just sometimes you just cart them all the way up there to Swan Hill. It's a long drive and back. Maybe it just takes a bit out of them. But anyway, we'll just see how she pulls up and what they say, whether she goes to the paddock or whether we push on. But I suppose you'd be disappointed with today.
Dean said between stall and today, she just felt flat in her finish.
Well, that's kind of how she raced.
Yeah, yep. So that's our runners that we've had. Obviously, Tiberian was our winner and a couple other neat runs there to look forward to the future with. Tomorrow, we have Serious Witness, 2200 at Geelong.
Right.
Yeah, on the synthetic, Caitlin Mellion.
Right.
Drawn.
Who's going there?
I'll go.
You'll go.
Yeah, I'll go.
Oh, now you're Ballarat. You'll go everywhere.
Everywhere, hey? Man.
10 minute, man. He can go anywhere now.
I was actually talking to Matt Kamani at the trials this morning. I said, oh, gate 11. He said, good. So we
outside's a go there.
Yeah, just to keep her up. And
I've got concerns about that tight track for a big stride in filly.
Matt did as well. Yeah.
But he's the one elected to go there. So we'll hang him out to dry if it doesn't work out. But she needs to win this race.
Yeah. Later that night, Wanted Diva, the filly that we had at Caulfield a couple of weeks ago, she finds a barrier one in a 1,200 metre maiden. Obviously a big drop in class.
I hate barrier one.
Yeah, we seem to get one or outside at the moment.
Young horses in one's not a good thing, but look, she ran quite well there. Had her first up run on that big day at Caulfield.
Yep.
And whilst it was all too much for her and it was probably the wrong move strategically, had to have a crack at the cash that big Vobis Gold day, but I think she did all right there. Look, if she's any good, she's going to be finishing top three.
Luke Nolan stays on. Saturday, we've got a big day Saturday.
Have we?
Yes, we have. Well, I'll go to Adelaide first, Broadway first. Goes back to same distance and track that he won on last up.
Who rides?
Damien Lane.
D-Lane.
D-Lane from gate 8.
Jay Allen sacked. D-Lane on.
Yeah. Poor old Johnny hadn't done much wrong since then. He rode about 10 winners.
Harsh, aren't they?
Phew, the owners. D-Lane. There you go.
Gets the money. Gets him the money and they just cut him off like they don't care.
Fair replacement anyway.
I saw Johnny Allen down at Warrnambool speaking of the carnival last week.
Yeah.
With his young lady in hand.
Yeah, young Emma.
Punching above his weight, I reckon.
Probably is, yeah.
Punching above his weight, young Johnny.
Yeah, no, he's...
I don't know what he said. Had a conversation with him. Couldn't understand a word he said. He had a couple of drinks too.
I'll tell you what, he's absolutely riding a treat at the moment.
Seems to come into his own this time of year.
Yeah, it must be the jumps reinvigorates him again. But,
I think he's just excited to be in a country where it's not minus 10.
Yeah, probably. Probably, but...
Anyway, so Broadway and first.
Got to be a top chance, huh?
Got to be top three.
Oh, it's
be a stronger race than last
time. Yeah, it's a same money sort of race, but the carnival's well and truly
a stronger race. Yeah. I'd say he's a top three chance.
Yep. Doomben, we'll go to the other end of Australia. We have our smart little filly with Tani Gollan. She's our star in a Group 2.
Bit of an ask.
Moe Champagne Classic. First up, Robbie Fradd.
Yeah, well...
Gate 3.
She's a good two-year-old, been a good two-year-old so far. Two starts, a first and a third. Third was the Hootson, had excuses that day, had a good break coming back. See him flies around here when it's dark. Coming back, first up, 1200 is a bit of a concern, drawn three, second favourite behind the Chris Waller horse. Yeah, if she's fit enough and she gets the right run, she can be in the finish. Top three finish, group two race, makes her a very valuable filly. If she wins, there'll be a lot of Moe and Shandon drank. I think most of the owners are making the trip up, which including young Liz.
Liz is going.
Yep. She's booked and going. Looks like I'm feeding on my own, or you can come and help me Saturday, Pete.
Close enough now.
Only up the road. That's good to know, actually. Yeah. I might roster you on. So look, she's got to be an each way show. My only query is, I wish it was 1100, not 1200.
Yeah, I did one of the 12, but anyway, the trainer seems keen. She's working well. Donald, back in Victoria, Stringer Bell. He finds a really winnable race.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Get on.
He finds a real winnable race, I reckon.
Get on.
Jack Hill's on. Obviously, we've got...
He doesn't want to jinx it.
Jockeys left.
He doesn't want to jinx it.
Winner on the track, 1200.
Just wins, doesn't he?
Oh, gee, I just...
Disappointed.
Don't want to say
if
it.
If he doesn't win, go.
Yeah, exactly. If he doesn't, would be disappointed. No, it just looks a good race.
There you go. Take it from Australia's leading tipster, Peter Morganti.
That pulls us up, Darren.
Is that it?
That pulls us up.
So after Saturday, nothing?
No, we had... I can't think of the thing. Connery was nominated. He trialled Wednesday, but...
Trialled all right, too.
Yeah, Archie was a little disappointed, but he puts it down to maybe that Geelong synthetic.
I wasn't disappointed.
No, I thought it was good, but...
Yeah. He had the winner of that trial.
Hard taskmaster, Archie. He just wants to win now, not thirds.
Get it back on camera.
Me? Oh, yeah. I disappeared there. Head to his place.
Where are you going?
I nearly fell over at the drain.
I was down in the drain.
Yeah, right. High Largo was nominated for the synthetic at Geelong.
A bit soon.
Yeah,
don't want her on the synthetic.
I would have thought,
way.
Give her another week and find somewhere 2,000
on the
tracker. Grass.
Yeah, yeah.
After that, there's not much. We're probably...
Largo? Is he going to run anytime soon?
Well, he trialled okay this morning.
Oh, you went to the trials.
Yes, I went to the trials.
Well, we have about 12 trialling.
Six.
Only six?
Only six, yeah.
Who was the pick of them? Did you watch him?
Yeah, no, I just tried to think. Falago trial, well, his plans are he will trial, he's going over the jumps here next Wednesday.
In a trial?
In a trial.
Not a race.
No, not a race.
The hand is just fell off the couch.
Heading to the Casterton Cup.
Casterton Cup, we've won that.
Weary just said, we'll spark him up over the jumps and we'll go and have a kill at Casterton.
Roger. Big Roger will be up there, the mayor of Casterton.
Yeah. Perugia trialled really well. Obviously would have ran tonight, but didn't get a run for
the
emergency.
Didn't have to go.
No, but T1, he might have just got blazed on the line, but Damien Lane was as quiet as a church mouse. He was fairly keen to know the name of him afterwards.
Can you hear think, babe?
Yeah, that's him. I want to go home.
I believe Yogi went good.
Oh, yeah. He was probably the pick. Amazing, these horses. Once you get them out to 1350, I know Johnny Allen had to wake
finally,
him up.
Finally, we're trialling stayers over proper distances. Well, finally, Pete.
It is an issue in Victoria.
Finally.
We should have more 1300 or 1400 metre trials.
Put that on Twitter.
Weary's got enough to make up his trials over
Put
1400.
On Twitter.
So he hit the line like.
Yeah. He's back.
So he goes to Bendigo Sunday week over a mile, first up. Yep. And. Perugia, there's a two-year-old at Geelong tomorrow week.
Do you reckon it's 3 degrees here?
I reckon it's -3. It got cold the last 10 minutes.
Jeez, so that might be on in the truck.
The old producers go wind them up. Now, I haven't got too much more there, Darren.
You got nothing, have you?
No, sales Wednesday. We're not.
Sovereign Wealth trial pretty good during the week.
Yeah, Michelle was happy with that.
Just looking for a race now.
Yep. She did mention something about a 1400 at Warrnambool.
Yeah.
I think it was early.
It's probably
June.
A good idea.
Yep. What was the other?
Breeders' Night coming up.
Yeah, June the 8th. I think that was the
date. Anyone going?
I've had a couple of replies. Have you?
Yeah, I got a half dozen there.
Yep. So, well,
that's
be
limited
good.
That night because it's not a very big venue, but it should be good fun, and we'll have a couple of interesting speakers to come along and talk all things breeding for those that are interested in finding out a little bit more about it and how it works. And because, it's a bit different to racing.
Yes.
But a lot of people are racing fillies and they might want to breed them on. So it's a good way to come along and find out the ins and outs.
Yep. Find it interesting.
And have a
yourself.
Drink and a sausage roll.
And a sausage roll. Not a steak.
A sausage roll.
Steak and a red wine.
Now, we're more beer and sausage
rolls. Yeah, I reckon I'm probably keen on that myself.
All right.
Yes.
Well, that's ATB here at Darren Weir's Twilight. It actually looks better on the camera than it does outside, doesn't it?
It looks like it's midday there, but not here.
There's no one here.
No. Nah.
The place is deserted.
He's not here.
We could chuck a couple of Group 1 horses on the truck and bugger off. A
couple here, I reckon. I reckon they just took off, actually.
Ah.
Blackheart Bar. Ah,
not
Blackheart
Bar. They'll be all off to the airport, wouldn't they?
Oh, well, the one's going to Adelaide.
Oh, Adelaide.
Yeah, well, actually, ours just went, probably. Broadway first.
Didn't you see him get on the truck?
No, they went a bit earlier.
Oh, you missed it. Yep. Right. Well, that's all we've got, because I've got to take these horses home, rug them, feed them,
and then
clean the truck out, and then go inside, and hopefully Liz has got dinner ready.
Sausage roll and a beer.
Something better be something better than that. It's been a long day. Well, who's your best for the week?
I like Stringer Bell.
Stringer Bell. $1.80?
Yeah, it won't be much more, I wouldn't have thought. No, you might get Black and White Figures just on his first up run.
You going?
Yeah, I'm heading to Donald, yeah.
It's good. Yeah. So, Saturday morning, you're going to help me feed and then go to Donald. Geez, you're in for a big day.
Yeah. Is that helicopter in vogue, is it?
I'll give you a push bike. What, no, you deserve?
No.
So, how is it, Ballarat? You know, if you run a month?
Yeah, I've been here 3 days. Got a bloody garage full
Haven't been to a servo for 3 days, probably.
No. Been a backers, though. It's just down the road, unfortunately.
Oh, no. There goes the old diet.
Diet was put on hold for about 4 days over the weekend.
You enjoyed moving, though, I heard.
Oh,
really enjoyed it.
Oh,
loved
Jesus.
It.
Never again.
Never again? No. You're only renting. You'll be moving.
I'm dying in Ballarat. No, look, it was good, and we're in now, and, look, it's just different. Been in a small country town most
Can't
of
wait.
My life.
I'm excited. I've got some jobs for you.
It was nice actually getting up at Cord Date and being at Burrumbeater 5 Date this morning instead of 5 o'clock. And,
excellent.
Yeah, 10 all minutes right. out here and it's all good.
Well, I'm Darren Dance with the Ballarat-based Morganti. Till next week, happy punting.
Do it for your name, but there's gonna be a day.